Have you ever found yourself with too much choice, knowing that whichever watch colourway you choose needs to be the exact right one, or you will end up with that horrible feeling of being hugely regretful? And even worse, eventually having a watch envy, followed by that inevitable hatred towards other watch enthusiasts who have the colourway you know you should have originally gone for. Today, we're taking a close look at the Aquareef, a diver's watch featuring a dual timer from a new microbrand called Golby, who are launching on Kickstarter in December 2023, with a choice of six fantastic colourways, as we take a close look at the black and yellow, and we delve deep into this watch and cover every single aspect of it, as I always try to do for you, my lovely, lovely viewers, all eight of you. And keep a lookout for my usual walk around at the end of my vid as I take the Golby Aquareef around a very autumnal Skipton castle, over 900 years old and one of England's best preserved castles, before wandering around the fantastic Skipton woods that runs adjacent to the castle, here in the wonderful town of Skipton in North Yorkshire, here in leafy England. As ever, it's great to have you here. Now let's look at an overdramatic specification of this watch, all in the next 90 seconds. Golby is a brand new UK-based microbrand created by Craig Golby, who wanted to create a long-lasting legacy of his surname and thus created the Aquareef as his first venture into the microbrand world. And the name Aquareef was born from Craig's love of the sea, and in particular the Cornish Sea in the United Kingdom. And the name Aquareef is also a huge nod to the 90s band Reef. And this, in my absolutely grubby but very moisturised hands today, is the black and yellow. And the choice was given to me by the guys at Golby to pick between this, the black and orange, the black and teal, white and orange, white and teal, and white and navy. And I must say, I was torn, really, really torn. I mean, as far as colourways for a series of a watch go, I have to say that the choice you are going to get is absolutely exceptional. I mean, I've seen product launches and established brands release colour variations of a new product release, and yeah, there's usually one or two nice colours in amongst a few duds with many of those product releases, but literally with the Aquareef, I have to say that I had so much want over every single colour that is available. I had images of picking the wrong one, The white and orange, two colours that are kryptonite to me, was where my eyes went to initially. But then the teal on the black, or then the teal on the white. I had images of picking one, then seeing my Instagram feed in the future with other colourways, and me getting those horrid green eyes of pure envy, jealousy, and pure hatred. So I just knew I had to pick the right colour. And here it is, after a lot of to-ing and fro-ing, a lot of patience from Craig, the black and yellow is in my hands, and I thought that would be that, but there's still a lot of want for the other colour variations, in particular that white and orange, and I don't think that will ever go. Anyway, so just to reiterate what was said in a cool and pretty awesome 90 second spec, I'm quite proud of that one. This, the Aquareef, comes in at 13.1mm thick, including the crystal, 50.5mm lug-to-lug, 42mm in diameter, 20mm at the lug, with this 316L stainless steel bracelet tapering right down to 16mm at the clasp. The dial, wow, I mean, where do I start? Okay, first and foremost, the dial features these oil-pressed wavy lines that span across the dial, and that pattern is actually a feature in all the colour variations of the Aquareef, and it obviously is a nod to the influence of the ocean, and in a bit of an odd way gives a bit of rhythm to this dial. The applied hour markers are all the same size, battened, white with a Lume centre, and a gunmetal grey perimeter, adding to a bit of boldness to an otherwise small set of hour indices. I'd say especially for a diver's watch, with Golby opting not to go for larger indices or, I don't know, an inverted triangle or beaver's teeth at the 12, but actually that same size of hour markers all the way around the dial actually adds a bit of uniformity to what is a pretty energetic dial design. There are no hour numerals, and also note the 3 o'clock, which houses the day complication, white text, and on a dial coloured background. And adding to that dial is the Golby logo under the 12, and probably, dare I say, and I hate to say, my biggest dislike of this watch, I don't know, I just feel like it's a little bit on the large side, with perhaps, I don't know, a cool looking G would have sufficed. Again, totally subjective. I also think that the square of the logo adds a bit too much complexity when sharing the dial with another square, which is the day complication. It's kind of like having two boxes on the dial when there only really needs to be one. You also have the limited edition status on either side of the 12, and three sets of info between the pinion and the 6. The product name in caps and in yellow, the automatic status below it in lowercase, and the water resistant status underneath it in caps. On the perimeter of that dial is this minutes track printed, larger lines representing the minutes, with smaller lines indicating a quarter of a second. The hands are sword hands, and I must say, really stand out against what could be considered as a bit of a busy dial. White in the middle with an outline here in yellow, and every colour variant available has hands outlined in their respective primary colour. And for me, really adding to a very bold, strong looking, assertive appearance. The tip of the hour hand falls 2.5mm from the inside edge of the hour index, with the tip of the minutes hand falling bang on the ring of the minutes track and perfectly eclipsing the hour indices as it passes them by. The seconds hand sports an elongated triangle about 2.5mm from its tip, the tip hitting the minutes track perfectly, and that tip of the elongated triangle on the seconds hand meeting the hour index absolutely spot on. The seconds hand is counterbalanced, and you'll notice that it's in yellow, white in the centre of the triangle, but actually that yellow only starts 2.5mm from the pinion, which gives this seconds hand a bit of a floating effect around the dial. And that dial is contained within this internally rotating chaptering, and a very key aspect to this watch, being that it's not only the dominating feature of this watch, given that it sports its key primary colourway, in this case yellow, but it's actually numbered between 1 and 12 with 4 vertical markers in between. It is actually designed to track a second time zone without the traditional fourth hand you'll find on a GMT watch. And that inner rotating chaptering is controlled by the second crown, which is positioned at the 2 o'clock. And just to note that this is a prototype, with the final production run planned to sport slightly larger numerals on that inner chaptering, similar to how the numerals and markers sit on the bezel. And speaking of which, and finishing off the face of this watch, is this dominating ceramic bezel in black, and sandwiches that yellow chaptering perfectly from a colours perspective, in my opinion. Now, this being a proto, is a 90 click, but the final production will be 120 click. It's fairly straightforward, inverted triangle at its default 12 o'clock position, and interestingly, this watch is only inverted triangle. There are numerals every 10 minutes and minute markers that are, I hate to say, a little pet hate of mine, three individual minute markers in between the numerals and the 5 minute markers. And I say pet hate of mine, it's only because it drives my OCD around the bend. But look, there's absolutely nothing wrong with the bezel itself or its design, and I'm probably more so highlighting deficiencies within myself. So, wow, look, overall, a lot of thought and consideration has gone into the entire face of this watch, into that dial, into the hands, and into the chapter ring in particular, to give this watch a bit of a quirky hybrid of a dual timer and traditional diver's watch, and all in all feeling very bold, very masculine, with the finesse of attention to detail. For me, there's also very clear and exceptional colour coordination factored into this watch too. And the face of this watch is lit up with a RT9 lume on the hour markers, hands and bezel markers. As ever, there's not much more I can say about the lume, as it very much speaks for itself. The crystal is a flat sapphire crystal, adding to the overall robustness of this diver's watch, and this prototype has AR coating, but the guys at Golby are planning to add a higher grade of AR on the final production pieces. Now, the case is made from 316L stainless steel, is vertically brushed and spans a juicy 50.5mm from lug to lug, and actually follows the curvature of the bezel around both sides of the case and dips fairly narrow at the lugs to house a bracelet that has a lug width of 20mm as opposed to 22mm. The case is, like I say, 316L stainless steel and also sports these two crowns. The primary crown at the 3 is a screw down crown, coin edge, signatured with the G element of the Golby logo, and I measured it in at 6.4mm in diameter. Now, the secondary crown at the 2 o'clock is slightly smaller at 5.8mm in diameter, and as you can see, the stem of that crown protrudes higher in comparison to the primary screw down crown, and I actually quite like that, as opposed to two crowns looking exactly the same. It feels much more like a control panel. And just a note too, that this watch is water resistant to 10 ATM or 100 meters, obviously fine for the majority of us shallow sea swimmers and snorkelers, and I'm hoping that if Golby go down the route of a second product line of dive watches, it would be great to see one of 200 meters in water resistance. The bracelet is an oyster style bracelet, 20mm at the lug and tapers right down to 16mm by the time it gets to this clasp. Now, this prototype has male endlings, and as you can see, the center link at the lug does protrude ever so slightly, but Golby have stated that they are going to re-engineer the endlink a little bit more so that it sits better on the wrist. The clasp is a deployment clasp, and the buckle houses a lift and slide micro adjuster that allows for micro adjustments on the fly without the need for any tools, and allowing for up to 9mm of movement. Fantastic if you're donning a wetsuit, ready for that dip into the big blue. So I get that the clasp is large as a make weight to the micro adjuster, but the size of that clasp is maybe a little bit too large if you're not in the ocean, and 99.9% of the time, rather, on your desk, in the office, it can be prone to a bit of desk rash in that case. The movement is an NH35A movement, 21,600 beats per hour, 24 joules, 41 hours of power reserve, hacking seconds, hand windable, and a bit of a Trojan, and ever reliable, and one of the world's most popular movements. I mean, yeah, 21,600 BPH is all she's got, but I think that the introduction of quarter seconds on the minutes track actually makes this movement stagger feel much more like a lovely little sweep. And that movement is contained behind this case back, and yes, it's an exhibition case back, sapphire crystal, and okay, it's displaying an NH35A movement, but actually it's not the worst movement in the world to showcase, and you've got the Golby brand on the rotor, so that's a nice little touch. You've got some spec on the perimeter, but obviously no serial number with this being a prototype. On my 7.5-inch wrist, it wears, well, what can I say, in terms of comfortability, it wears absolutely really, really well. With the lug-to-lug over 50mm in addition to male endlings, I was a little worried that I may be too large, even for my size wrist, but actually it fits really well. Saying that, I'm looking forward to seeing the final production piece with better fitting endlings, which I think will make the bracelet drop down a little better around the wrist. I mean, let's be honest, with the lug-to-lug over 50mm in addition to 42mm in diameter as a big old watch, but I don't know, it feels like it wears a little bit more compact than what the dimensions would suggest. I think that keeping the height down to near 13mm, including sapphire crystal, has been brilliant considering that it houses a fairly big bezel and a fairly deep chaptering. Now I've had similar sized watches with 22mm lug widths, but actually this bracelet is 20mm at the lug and tapers down nicely, so that really does add to a lighter and more compact feel on the wrist. 165 grams on the wrist isn't too bad for a wrist full of masculinity in my opinion. Aside from what I said before about the clasp, it actually does look very masculine on my wrist, and I'm always funny about branded clasps whereby the brand runs horizontally along the clasp. Looks okay when I showcase this on my left wrist for this section of my review, and I do that bearing in mind that 99% of wearers wear their watch on their left wrist, but I'm actually left-handed, so I actually wear mine on the right. So then when I do that, the brand name appears upside down, but I can live with that being the oddity that I unfortunately am. In terms of price, the Golby Aquareef will launch on Kickstarter at an amazing £250, approximately $312 US, €285 in today's market for the super early bird first party, first three orders, with a rate then going up to 280 UK pound sterling, 350 USD and €320 for the next 100 early birds, with the final tier of pricing being set at 299 UK pound sterling, 375 USD, €340, and the RRP at 499 UK pound sterling, 625 USD, or €570. Now you may have plenty of competition to get that ridiculously good price for the first three to party, but certainly give it a shot if you can, and if you fail, get on that early bird rate, because the price is utterly insane in my opinion for such a fantastic looking watch with a really good spec. Now the dreaded choice of colourway will come as and when this gets funded, so you'll have plenty of time to mull over the choices. Unless of course you go for what Golby offer as the full Monty, all six watches at 1550 UK pound sterling, approximately 1940 USD or 1770 euros, representing proportionally around about the first to party rate on all six models. Now there's food for thought, but just remember that all the conversions from pound sterling to USD and euros that I've just said are in today's market. Overall, well, what can I say? It's been absolutely epic having this in my collection over the last few weeks, taking it around the beautiful Yorkshire town of Skipton and Skipton Castle. I really feel like I've properly rambled on in this vid for a while, but the truth is that for me, there's nothing, and I mean nothing more exciting than a new entry into the microbrand world. I mean, I love watches, but more so I love small microbrands, new microbrands that focus entirely on the successful launch of their product range, and I'm particularly excited about this one. British-led, British-designed, inspired by the sea in and around our beautiful island, and a stunner at that. I love that it's a dual timer, a dive watch, and has a really nicely designed dial that has had a lot of thought put into it on the back of a lot of inspiration from this beautiful country I live in. It really is a lovely watch, and the price set for its Kickstarter launch is incredible in my opinion. And if you back this Kickstarter launch, I honestly don't think you'll be disappointed. The only real issue you'll have is exactly which colourway you want to go for. So beware, make the right choice, otherwise your eyes will go green with envy when you see your other watch enthusiast buddies post the colourways you were umming and ahhing about.